Welcome, racquetball fans, to the 2017 Georgia Open. I'm Laura McCormick with the World Racquetball Tour, and this is our first quarterfinal of the day. We are live at Recreation ATL. We have Rodrigo Montoya serving against Gerardo Franco to open up our quarterfinals. Our referee is Alex Kerr. He's a local here in Lilburn, Georgia. Franco with a quick side out in the service box now. It's 0-0. Oh, and the first point for Gerardo Franco. One serving, 0. This should be an interesting matchup for our first quarterfinal today. Gerardo Franco and Rodrigo Montoya have never matched up before in the quarterfinals. Gerardo Franco, a consistent quarterfinalist on the WRT. Franco is 18 years old out of San Luis Potosí, Mexico, and Rodrigo Montoya is from Chihuahua, Mexico. Strong start for Franco. He's leading, which means Montoya is down right now at 0-3 in game one. First point for Montoya, 1-3. Gerardo Franco, if we take a look back through the draw, defeated Jim Minkle from Kathleen, Georgia, 15-7, 15-10. Then he had a tough match in the round 16s against Wayne Antone, who is from Eugene, Oregon, and playing this weekend. Those two went to breaker. Gerardo Franco winning game one, 15-4, losing game two, 13-15, and winning in the tiebreaker, 11-9. I talked to Franco about the match last night, and he said he was leading in game two when Wayne Antone really turned it up and started to come back, and Franco found himself in a deficit. And the same thing happened in the breaker. So it was a tough toss-up. Wayne Antone could have been here today in the quarterfinals. And talking to Wayne, that's what his goal is as well. He's looking ahead. If he can get to the quarters, then he can keep pushing through as both the young players, Wayne Antone and Gerardo Franco, start making their way and pushing their way through to these upper level pros. Rodrigo Montoya, number three on the WRT, seeded number three this weekend as well. He played against Ryan Summerford in round 32s and then defeated Destry Everhart, also from Alabama, to get here against Gerardo Franco in the quarterfinals. You can take a look at the draw, which is posted on worldracquetballtour.com. It's also on R2Sports and the short link bit.ly/ATL draw. Another point for Montoya as he closes the gap and that lead that Franco had. Three serving four. Nice down the line for Montoya. Ties it up 4-4. On a skip from Montoya, gives Franco the side out. Looks like these guys are still waking up a little bit out there as Montoya ran into the ball. Franco leads 5-4. Four serving five. This is game one of our first quarterfinal of the 2017 Georgia Open. Traditionally, we see a lot of power from Montoya, and he's a very calm and collected player on the court, whereas Gerardo Franco, also calm out there, very fast. He's a quick player. Tied up 5-5. Get from Montoya. Solid from Franco, that ball kind of coming right back to him. If you want to see some crazy gets from Rodrigo Montoya, you should check out the YouTube channel for the World Racquetball Tour and like us on Facebook. We post lots of highlights on there, including an incredible one between Montoya and Cardona from the Longhorn Open. And Franco takes the lead again, 6-5. Six, five. off-speed shot from Montoya for a point to tie it up 6-6. I'd like to see that power and control from him. Two quick points in a row for Montoya makes it 7-6. Remember on the WRT, we play best 2 out of 3, first 2 games to 15, breaker to 11. There's 2 timeouts in each game and 2 minutes between each game. Neither player has used their timeouts yet. Still early. Montoya with 3 points in a row, taking back control of game one. Timeout called from Gerardo Franco as he skips point number 9 for Rodrigo Montoya. We'll be back in just a moment with more from Recreation ATL. Rodrigo Montoya is leading right now 9-6 in game one. For those of you that want to check out the draw, we'll get that up on the screen shortly, but you can go to r2sports.com. We also have it posted on World Racquetball Tour, or you can go to bit.ly/ATL draw. Good timeout for Gerardo Franco, who had skipped it to give Montoya his 9th point, and now he gets the side out and that break in momentum that he was looking for with that timeout. Rodrigo Montoya is a player who can take over and kind of take control, and Franco did a good job of slowing him down. Another smooth touch from Montoya, showing that power is not all you need in racquetball as he gets the side out. And he has another opportunity to score now. He leads 9-6. Franco looking for a screen from Montoya. He's talking with our referee, Alex Kerr. But the point stands. Montoya leads 10-6. Short serve. Montoya will serve again. Quick reaction from Franco. Six serving 10. clear. Montoya releasing that power from the center court with that swing. He leads now 11-6. We have our front view camera. This is the first time we've used it in Georgia. This is the third time the WRT has been at Recreation ATL. We thank Georgia and all the sponsors for making it possible, including Grace Warrior Ministries, for bringing the WRT back. We'll be back again in September for the fourth time. So it's two times in 2017. You can get details on the WRT schedule at worldracquetballtour.com. Montoya leads 12-6 in game one. Montoya able to capitalize on that setup. Puts himself in a game point situation now. It's 14-6. Gerardo Franco sides him out, staves off that game point. Six serving 14. Skip from Montoya, another point for Franco as he holds on. It's 7-14. Another point for Gerardo Franco, two in a row, 8-14. Franco was the recipient of the 2015 Sportsmanship Award, which is voted on by both fans and players. That voting at the end of every year. Another point for Franco. I like his focus right now as he wins 3 points in a row. He's not allowing Montoya to phase him. First pinch didn't work for Franco. Montoya sides him out. Second game point for Rodrigo Montoya. 14-9. And he wins it on an ace. Rodrigo Montoya winning game one, 15-9 over Gerardo Franco. We'll be back in just a moment with more of the WRT Georgia Open live from Recreation ATL, so don't go anywhere. Defense from Montoya. First point for Gerardo Franco. Ooh, and those two getting jammed up in the middle. Our referee, Alex Kerr, calls a replay. One serving zero. Montoya is currently ranked number 3 on the World Racquetball Tour. You can get those rankings at worldracquetballtour.com. And he also has 3 WRT championships under his belt. Side out for Franco, 18 years old from San Luis Potosi, Mexico. A lot of players coming out of there. We'll see Andre Padilla later in our quarterfinals, who's also from San Luis. Good save from Franco, kind of waits on it. We also have a player missing in action this weekend. Polo Gutierrez is not with us. He's been nursing an injury from his elbow, and unfortunately, or fortunately, he had to end up having the surgery yesterday. So we wish Polo Gutierrez a speedy recovery. We hope everything is going well and to see him back on the tour soon. First point for Montoya. Nope, excuse me, that was a side out. It's 0-2. Short serve, he'll get a second. Coming up after this, we do have more quarterfinals. David Bobby Horn, Jake Bredenbeck, Jaime Martel and Andre Padilla, and Alex Cardona and Kevin Vasquez. There we go, first point for Montoya. One serving, two. Two serving, two. Montoya takes the lead 3-2. This is the third time the WRT has been in Recreation ATL for an event. Previous winners include Alex Cardona, who won in 2015, and Andre Padilla, who won in 2016, defeating Polo Gutierrez. And we'll see Padilla in the third quarterfinal of the day. He'll be taking on Jaime Martel. But first we'll have David Bobby Horn and Jake Bredenbeck, which I thought felt like a throwback to 2015. We saw those matchups previously, which we'll talk about as those matches get underway. But it's interesting how the rankings obviously continue to move as new players come into the draw and start playing more events like Rodrigo Montoya. Montoya won his first ever title in October 2016 at the Pleasanton Open. Montoya defeated Alex Cardona for his first singles title. And since then, he's really been able to make his way up through the ranks. He's currently number 3. Gerardo Franco first started playing with the WRT technically in 2014, but 2015 was when we started to see him more consistently on the tour, and he is a consistent quarterfinalist with the WRT. So it'll be interesting to see when he can kind of push through and start becoming a consistent semifinalist, but we're happy to have both players on the WRT. Right now, this is game two. Montoya is leading 4-2. Reaction from Franco wasn't good enough. Another point for Montoya. It's 5-2. Montoya's two additional titles were at the Longhorn Open in January of 2017, and then in February he won the Mount Rainier Open in Seattle, Washington. Long rally and a skip from Montoya. Timeout called, and we'll take a quick break as well. But don't go anywhere, because there's more of the WRT at Recreation ATL in just a moment. Gerardo Franco stepping back out onto the court, ready to keep the pressure on Montoya. For details on what the WRT has coming up next, make sure you go to worldracquetballtour.com. Find our full schedule there. Franco serving 2-5. This is game two. Short serve. We'll get a second serve. Referee is Alex Kerr. He's a local here at Recreation ATL. We'd like to thank him for reffing with us today. Montoya leads 6-2. Smooth backhand from Franco for the side out. Two serving six. Thank you. 7-3, Montoya leads in game two. Good shot for Franco. Gives him an opportunity to score now. It's 3-7. Tough serving from Montoya. He gets an ace. It's 8-3. He goes for that serve again, but this time it's short. Second serve. Bit of a slowdown now in game two as these two are locked a little bit at 8-3. And a skip from Franco gives a point to Montoya. It's 9-3. Rally and a side out for Gerardo Franco. I like to see the sportsmanship between the two of them. You could see Montoya nodding his head. That was a good rally for Franco, and Franco helping him up off the floor. I was just checking the WRT Facebook feed and messages, and I know both the mothers of Montoya and Franco are watching, so shout out to Maritza Gonzalez and Christina Solis. Franco serving now, it's 3-10. Montoya hits the floor a lot. You can catch some highlights from both Montoya and Franco on the YouTube channel for the World Racquetball Tour. And of course, I hope you follow us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram at World Racquetball Tour. You can also get details on the 2017 WRT schedule, ranking, and updates by going to worldracquetballtour.com. And a towel break also seems like an ideal time to tell you about an upcoming event for the WRT. We will be in San Luis Potosi, June 6th to the 10th. And again, you can get more details on our schedule by going to worldracquetballtour.com and following us on social media. We have some short videos and a promotion for that San Luis tournament coming up in June. It's 4 serving 10. Five-ten, quick point for Franco. Two quick points. For such a young player, Franco really has a good head on his shoulders. As I said, he's the 2015 recipient of the WRT Sportsmanship Award. He is 18 years old. And he is dedicated to racquetball right now. He's finishing up high school in San Luis Potosi. But he makes it out to a lot of tour stops. And I know that in the next year, he plans on continuing to do that. Rodrigo Montoya is from Chihuahua, Mexico. And he is currently studying engineering. He's in college right now. So props to the WRT players for getting their education. We'll talk more about our quarterfinalists and the education they have in their matches. Coming up after this, we have David Bobby Horn and Jake Bredenbeck, who were silver medalists at the Pan American Racquetball Championship last month at the Pan American Racquetball Championship in Costa Rica. Franco serving 7-10. That serve was long. Second serve for Montoya. Oh, and a diving get from Montoya, but that ball is down. Looks like Montoya is going to change his shirt, which is probably a good thing. We've had a couple towel wipe ups so far. Coming up next, we have Jake Bredenbeck and David Bobby Horn. And then right after that, our third quarterfinal is Jaime Martel and Andre Padilla. And we'll round out the quarterfinals today with Alex Cardona and Kevin Vasquez, who makes his first ever quarterfinal appearance. And of course, later this evening at 5 and 6 p.m. Eastern time, we will have the semifinals. You can get details on the draw by going to bit.ly/ATL draw, and you can see how these guys got here and who they will be facing coming up. It's game two, Franco serving 8-10. like that shirt change didn't do too much for Montoya. We still gotta take a break to wipe down the court. Gives the WRT an opportunity to thank our sponsors for making it possible to bring us to Recreation ATL, including United Stroke Alliance, OHE, TMT, Tennessee Machine Tool, and of course, Gearbox Racquetball. The official ball of the WRT is the Gearbox Black Ball. Timeout for Montoya. Looks like he has a broken string, so that doesn't count as using an official timeout. It's just an equipment timeout from the referee, which allows him to go in and switch out his racket. But then we can see Montoya on the left side of the screen calling an official timeout, which means we'll be back in 1 minute with more of our first quarterfinal, so don't go anywhere. Welcome back to the 2017 Georgia Open. And I hope you know that there's lots more racquetball coming up with the World Racquetball Tour. We have three events back to back in Mexico. The first one is Torneo Internacional Canals, WRT. That's at Lomas Racquet Club in San Luis Potosí, June 6th to the 10th. That is the home city for Andre Padilla and for Gerardo Franco. After that, we will be in Chihuahua, Mexico, and then the WRT Sonora Open. You can get those details at worldracquetballtour.com. This is game two. Montoya switching out his racket. He had a broken string, and then he called a timeout right away. So he's just hitting the ball to check out his racket. Franco making his way back and closing that gap. It's 9-10. Franco serving, it's 10-11 in game two. Franco has done a great job of keeping the pressure on Montoya and really sticking to playing his own game. Montoya staying calm and staying in control. He still has the 1 point lead. It's 11-10. unfortunate skip from Franco in the back of the court. Serve a little long. It'll be a second serve for Montoya. Looks like they'll replay that point. Point number 12 for Montoya. He's been going for his drive serve, but it's just a little off. He did ace Franco once or twice. We've seen some stellar serving from Montoya in the past. When he gets that serve just right, it's pretty deadly. That one is short, so he'll get a second serve. Timeout from Gerardo Franco. We'll be right back in just a moment with more of our quarterfinals from Recreation ATL. We're back at the quarterfinals with Rodrigo Montoya serving and leading 13-10 over Gerardo Franco. Get from Montoya. Soft and controlled from Montoya in the front row, and it's now his first match point. Franco was able to stave off Montoya twice in game one. Let's see if he can do the same right here in game two. There it is. Montoya wins game one, 15-10, which means he will move on to the semifinals later tonight at 5 p.m. Eastern time. Coming up next, we have David Bobby Horn and Jake Bredenbeck. We're going to go ahead and restart our feed, so we ask that you do the same at home as well. We'll be back in 10 minutes with our next quarterfinal, so don't go anywhere.